Abby, welcome to the Kelku Review Show. Today we have Joe joining us. Joe, what are you doing?
I thought I was here to do a video in 3D, and whenever I see people do anything to do with 3D, they're always doing this, touching the screen.
But
nothing's happening.
That's because we're reviewing a 3D product. We're not filming in 3D.
So these really aren't doing anything right now?
No. Actually, they're making you look amazingly stupid. That's what they're doing.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, sorry, everyone.
Yeah. Okay, you ready?
Yeah.
Yeah? You with us?
Let's go.
Okay. So, first product we're going to be reviewing is the Luminex. This is what it looks like. On the side here, it has this rotating viewfinder.
Nice noise.
Nice noise. It has a whole icon for that noise.
Wow.
Yeah. It's quite special.
It doesn't look that new, this camera, does it?
It looks very 80s. It looks like a little robot. Features are in 2D, 720p resolution, and in 3D, VGA.
That's not very good.
No, apparently not, which I've just learned today. On the back, if you look at the back, it's got a little gear stick, which is quite fun. I think that's quite fun. And here on the side, we have a rechargeable, changeable, replaceable battery.
That is good. A lot of cameras don't have those.
Yeah, no, exactly. It's great.
When your battery dies, the whole thing's dead.
Really?
But that's a good plus point, even if it doesn't look good.
Yeah. Yeah, but looking good is really important. Also, if you look on this viewfinder, it's going to make that noise again. Oh, no, we're fine.
It will.
Okay. As you can see, everything, when you look on the screen, is in 3D. But if you were to plug this into a TV, it wouldn't be in 3D unless you had a 3D TV.
Okay.
Okay.
Thanks for that.
That's fine.
It does actually look it looks better than I thought it would, actually.
It looks all right.
Yeah, with and without glasses. It is in 3D.
You can tell it's in 3D. You can't, yeah. But
I don't know what you do with it, though.
I know. It makes me feel a little bit sick.
Enough?
Yeah.
Okay. Interesting. So what was that one called?
Luminex. It's $299, which is quite a lot of money for something that, like you said, it does look like a little robot. Wally, whatever it's called, from Disney.
So this is the Panasonic HS900. It's a bit of a beast, and it comes with a beastly price tag of £950, which is the price we saw it on Pixmania for. The attachment here, which allows you to film 3D with it, is a further £260. So in total, it's a lot of money. The camera alone is only about that size, so this bit's the attachment. And this is a really, really, really good quality conventional camera with all the right numbers. So it's a lot of money. But it is significantly better than the camera Abby you don't look very impressed.
Just 3D in general, but sorry, carry on.
Hit
me with the facts.
I'm not sure you're ready for them, but I'm gonna go for it.
I'm ready.
1080p quality, okay. 3D recording. Mm-hmm. That walks all over that, the camera that you just showed us there.
Yeah.
So that's what you pay for, basically. £950, yeah, it's a lot of money, but the quality will be much, 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 much better. To actually view it in 3D, there's no 3D screen on the viewfinder. You do need to have a 3D TV to view it in 3D, which is slightly annoying, but it is a much more professional piece of kit.
Can you turn it round? Can you turn this round?
I can.
Oh.
Oh, only as far as that. You can film upwards or...
Okay, is that... Why does it turn?
Yeah, I don't think...
There we go. Women with technology.
So yeah, it's good. It's big though, isn't it? It's quite kind of...
It's quite, sort of cumbersome.
Quite chunky. You wouldn't want to walk around the street with that. Just, you know, it's definitely for someone who's wants to do something fairly good with their camera.
And you think this is useful?
Well, it depends.
You would
what you're
want
filming,
it,
really, isn't it? Yeah, I would want that. Yeah.
And finally, we have the Ape Tech 3D, which looks like this.
It's quite an unusual look for a camera, isn't it?
Sort of looks
like a phone.
Looks like a Game Boy.
Yeah, it does.
I think they're an 80s Game Boy.
So what? Are they two different camera? Two different lenses on the back.
Two different lenses on the back. Yep, to get that 3D thing. Films in 2D and in 3D, 720p resolution. and it has this USB stick, so you can transfer it onto your PC or laptop. And with the aid of the software that's provided, you can transfer it into the blue and red 3D, which you need these to watch with. Which means you can also upload it to YouTube 3D, which I just found out existed today.
Mm, very cool, isn't it, YouTube
yeah,
TV?
Yeah, and with that software as well, it means that you can watch it on a normal TV in 3D using these.
And then on a 3D TV, I can film straight from that.
Yeah.
Watching 3D, it's exactly the same as this one. So how much is it?
It's £99.
It's pretty cheap, isn't it?
It's pretty cheap.
For genuine 3D.
Yeah, and when you look through, you can set, you can see. That's the most I've seen that it looks in 3D. It's much better than that one looked in 3D.
I'm quite impressed. For 99 quid.
Yeah.
Even though it looks a bit like an old Game Boy.
Yeah. So which one would you go for?
Well, I like to think that I'm one of the best filmmakers I know. So for that very reason, I would have to have this one.
Right.
But then I'd have to get someone else to buy it for me because it's nearly £1,000. And even more if you want to get the 3D element on it too.
Right.
If I'm actually me, not being a pretentious idiot, talking about being a filmmaker, I'd probably get this one.
You would?
Yeah, I think so. This, £299 for that. That was £299, right?
Yeah.
200 quid more than this, and from what I can make out...
It's the same.
A lot of the same functions, actually better quality 3D.
Yeah.
So when you've got a £900 difference... In fact, no, with that £1,100 difference...
Yeah. And that could if you've... got a man pocket, that could fit in your pocket.
Yeah, that could fit in a man pocket, yeah.
Yeah. I personally, thanks for asking, wouldn't buy any of them because I don't see the point in 3D.
I'm just not ready for it.
No, I'm just not ready for the 3D cameras. I don't really get it.
It's gonna hurt when you are ready.
It's gonna hurt. Boom, it's just gonna hit me like lightning. I will wait for that moment in anticipation with a lot of excitement.